with Fabergé, one thing we're able to do is we're able to make people gasp. Our biggest compliment, just have that moment of wow, where someone almost takes a step back. In Fabergé's legacy, it's our privilege to be able to reference modern day culture and offer Fabergé as a bit of a platform. The Game of Thrones partnership started a few years ago. It was such an exciting challenge to imbue the story of Game of Thrones and maybe even the continuation of what could have been. Michele Clapton is obviously the creative sort of backbone of the series and what it has become. And so I think with her input, we knew straight away that it had to be an egg. It had to be a unique egg objet that was only going to be created once, you know, in a time and never again.
I think great design is all about detail. It's about, even if it's something very simple, whether it's simple or very complex, it's the small details, the angles, the curvatures, proportions, textures and colors.
So when Liisa and I first got together, we were talking about what, I guess, talking about, again, the colors and the journey of Dani and what it meant to her. And I just said that it was really important, I felt, that for me, each colour of Dana's journey, I mean, so she started in very pale mauve and whatever for her brother, then she became the blue when she married into the Dothraki, and that was a really strong time for her, and then eventually we see that seep into the red, and then to the black, which was the sort of darkness of her journey.
Fabergé back in the day also was a back then a storyteller already. We wanted to explore that further and sort of let our imagination run wild and also not be too restricted, not be too enslaved by our own history and things that maybe people would expect from us.
Egg is designed to make all the materials look as good as they can.
So I thought because we'd worked so hard on her costumes with embroidery and texture, and we would try to reflect again what was going around about her, so the embroidery and the smocking reflected her dragon skin. And so again, I thought it was really important to bring those textures into the egg.
The drawings were featuring some incredible shading of color from darker red all the way to brightest red. We were looking for the same glow within the main gemstones of the Game of Thrones egg, and possibly reproducing with gemstones that natural shading of color from the darkest to the lightest. The whole life of these gemstones can be accurately traced back to the origin. It has been an incredible journey.
This Game of Thrones egg opens in two parts. It has outer shell that opens to reveal another egg that is cut in the shape of dragons, and then that opens to reveal a crown.
I think the day they asked me to do it, within a couple of days, I was thinking, what could it be? And I just suddenly thought, of course the crown, because it's the one thing that the whole story is about, and it's the thing she never had. It's about creative thought and process. And I think it was really interesting when Liisa and I worked together how similar a lot of our approaches were, although it was in a completely different world, and actually how exciting we found each other's world.
The magic happens when different people come together with a common goal and create something that is unique and totally different and unexpected.
It is quite an iconic show. And to link it with something like Fabergé, which is obviously such an iconic brand, it will sort of be a celebration of two sort of areas of design.
The highest expectation we have is that it's a piece that lives on for, you know, many decades, that gets seen in many different places around the world, and was going to be really a global moment.